welcome to Snavio. I'm Ksenia, and in this video, we'll talk about how to avoid spam filters. In our previous video, we've gotten to know what spam filters are and how they work. If you haven't watched it yet, you'll find the video in the top right corner and in the video description. Now that we know what we're dealing with, it's time to learn how to deal with it. Unfortunately, there is no way to 100% safeguard yourself from spam filters, but there are ways to make this meeting much more pleasant. Here are some tips. First, avoid using dynamic IPs. A dynamic IP can be used by two or more people simultaneously, for example, while using the same ISP. Some email and SMTP service providers also dedicate an IP address to a group of users. The downside of this is that with the dynamic IPs, you cannot control the IP sender reputation. And as you know, low sender reputation means a higher chance to be flagged as a spammer. The solution is to use a dedicated IP address. A dedicated IP is a unique IP address associated with a specific hosted account that only you have access to, which will make it easier to maintain IP health and reputation. Check your IP reputation regularly. Make it a rule to check your IP reputation every month. There are numerous free apps that will help you do that. We recommend using Talos Intelligence, Sender Score, and RBL Tracker for more detailed reports. Set up SPF, DKIM, and DMARC. SPF, DKIM, and DMARC are three protection steps that save you from hackers, phishers, data capture, and help avoid the recipient spam folder. Sender Policy Framework, or SPF, is a special DNS record that contains all IP addresses that you can send emails from your domain. Domain Keys Identified Mail, or DKIM, is an authentication mechanism that uses encryption keys that prove that you're the sender. If you don't set up the DKIM, many mail servers will simply decline your emails. Domain-based message authentication, reporting, and conformance, or DMARC, is a protocol that defines what to do if your email hasn't passed the first two authentication steps, SPF and DKIM. Warm up new email accounts before starting large campaigns. Warming up an email account before starting an outreach is a must, especially if you're going to send a large number of emails. Remember, spam filters check how many emails are sent from the account, its sending frequency, engagement, and reaction to your emails. Start with a manual warm-up first. Manually send emails to the people you know and ask them to engage by opening them, clicking on links, and replying. Then, continue sending in small batches using automation, gradually increasing the number of emails per day. You'll find more info on the perfect warm-up strategy in the video in the top right corner, and we'll also add the link to it in the video description. Verify your email lists. First and foremost, we strongly advise against purchasing email lists. This is the fastest way to ruin your sender reputation and land in the spam folder. Secondly, regardless of how you collected the email list, always verify it before starting your campaign, even if you verified it before. Emails get abandoned, mistyped, or blocked every day, so make it a routine to clean your database regularly. Snavio Email Verifier is a great choice for keeping your list fresh and ready for any campaign. Create a separate email account for cold outreach. When sending cold outreach, you need to be 100% sure of your sender reputation, and it's quite a task when the whole company is using the same domain name and IP. That is why many companies create a separate domain and sender account for cold campaigns. This gives you the opportunity to control your sender reputation, easily monitor your campaign performance, and not worry about ruining your main domain's reputation in case something goes wrong. Be careful with HTML. Make sure that your code is impeccable. Badly coded HTML emails containing broken or incomplete tags will attract spam filters' attention and may even become the reason your email won't reach the recipient's inbox. So put the time into making your HTML template perfect or don't use it at all. Personalize your emails. Spam emails usually look the same and lack individual approach. Such emails are quickly detected and blocked by the spam filters. Personalizing your messages helps avoid this, and what's even better, leads to a higher engagement. With Snowbee Troop campaigns, you can add custom email variables that will add a human touch to your emails and improve your open, click-through, reply rate, and even conversions. Avoid spam trigger words. Spam filters analyze every detail, and that includes the language. Don't overuse such words and phrases like free, 50% discount, buy now, as they are persistently common in the spam emails and may trigger spam filters. There are hundreds of spam trigger words out there, and you can find and download a list of over 550 of the most common ones via the link in the video description below. Go easy on attachments. Email size plays an essential role in email deliverability. Attachments like Word documents and PDFs instantly alert spam filters. Instead of sending your file as an attachment, include a link to your document uploaded to your Google Drive. Files uploaded to Google Drive are automatically scanned for viruses and look trustworthy to both the ESPs and the recipients. Comply with email laws and regulations. For example, under the Can Spam Act, which is one of the major regulations alongside GDPR, every sender should follow certain rules. For example, their emails must contain an unsubscribe link and have at least one sentence. However, there are many countries that have developed their own laws that you may have to comply with. Research them beforehand or risk landing in the spam folder or worse, being fined. Monitor your bounce rate. Bounces are the emails that couldn't reach your recipients' inboxes. The larger the number of bounced emails, the bigger the damage to your sender reputation. The perfect bounce rate is, of course, zero, but it's only possible if you send zero emails. So try to keep it under 2% by regularly cleaning your email lists. Hope these tips will help you craft emails that will be liked by both your recipients and spam filters. Make sure you check out more of our videos on what spam filters are and how to reduce your spam report rate. As always, like, subscribe, and hit the notification button for more of our marketing and sales tips. See you!